Mars. NASA, SpaceX, all these companies are saying that they want to go to Mars. And the timelines are coming up pretty quick. Some people saying 2025, 2030, saying we have a civilization by 2050, but there's a problem. Not a lot of people understand what Mars is really like. So let's figure that out. First of all, Mars is actually pretty small. It's much smaller than Earth, being about half the diameter of Earth, and it weighs about a fourth of how much Earth weighs. It's still really heavy, because Earth is pretty massive, but it's only a fourth, which makes it actually the second smallest planet, with Mercury being the smallest. If you lived on Mars, you would actually weigh 38% less than you do now. So for example, if you weighed 200 pounds on Earth, you'd weigh a little over 70 pounds on Mars, which would make it nice. You could probably dunk a basketball pretty easily, but then if you have all that clunky astronaut gear, it actually probably weighs down some. But if you think about how small Mars is compared to Earth, you actually have a land area that is a little bit smaller than how much land is on Earth. Since most of Earth is actually two-thirds of Earth is covered by water, you have only a small portion of it that can be explored by land. And since Mars is much smaller than Earth, you have only 83% difference between how much land can be explored on Earth versus how much land can be explored on Mars. Speaking of land on Mars, Mars is actually home of the solar system's largest volcano. It is 370 miles in diameter and 13 miles high, stretching so far that it almost reaches outside of the Martian atmosphere. Now, to put that in the retrospect, Mount Everest is only 5 miles high, above sea level, that is. So when you compare 13 miles versus 5 miles and it's a volcano, that's a pretty big difference and something that would be really cool to explore on Mars. Now, when we talk about the atmosphere of Mars, it's actually very, very thin. It's less than 1% of that of here on Earth. So for example, if you blew up a balloon here on Earth, just a normal balloon, and you took that same balloon all the way over to Mars and let it go, it wouldn't only just expand a little bit like you might expect it to do in a hot day here on Earth, but it actually instantaneously pop, just because there's so much pressure on the inside and so little pressure in the Martian atmosphere that it would try to grow 100 times bigger and the balloon would just blow up. Now, when you think about how far Mars is away, it's actually 141 million miles away from the Sun. And because of that, it makes the Sun appear much smaller in the night sky. And since it's much farther, and since it's much smaller in the night sky, it also makes Mars much colder. The average temperature that is experienced on Mars is around negative 67 degrees Fahrenheit, which sounds pretty chilly, but it can get even lower to negative 153 degrees Fahrenheit, which is the lower range of what Mars experiences. With that being said, some of the hottest days that it's experienced has been 68 degrees Fahrenheit positive, so it's actually pretty nice on a nice day, on a hot day. But on a cold day, it could get really chilly really fast. Now again, to put that in retrospect, negative 128.6 degrees is the coldest that Earth has ever experienced, and that's been in Antarctica. So there's a major difference between the negative 153 degrees and the negative 126 degrees. One of the last things that's interesting about Mars is it's actually really close to the asteroid belt, and because of it, it has two moons. But these moons aren't like the moons that we think of. These moons are actually pretty small asteroids, and it's been thought that these actually came from the asteroid belt, and when Mars got too close to them, its gravity actually picked them up and surrounded them around a Martian orbit. So it's not like the moon that you think of in the sky that's this big, massive thing, but instead it's just a relatively small rock. And lastly, if you think about a day on Mars versus a day on Earth, a day on Mars is actually about the same time. How long it takes to go about its axis once is only 40 minutes longer than what it is here on Earth. But when you look at a year, that's a big difference. It's actually 687 days for Mars to go around the Sun. And that's might be a problem for astronauts that go there, because that means they'll only experience Mars birthdays only once every 1.9 years, which means if you lived on Mars, you'd only have a birthday about half the amount of time that you do here on Earth, which wouldn't be fun, but maybe they would have half birthdays or something like that, or they would still celebrate the Earth birthday, but that would be a lot of calendar stuff to figure out. So that's all the information I have on Mars. Next up, we're going to talk about why go to Mars and what the importance of it is. And with that, thank you, and I look forward to our next one.